When the religions affirm that God is one alone, they are not wronging, but are not completely agree about the real meaning of the number one, that is attributed to something of absolute as God. God is absolute, and as absolute may be one only in the relative expression of a mathematic power. In fact, saying God the only one means a determination in this unity, while God is not determinate. This may be the only one attribution to God, the full latch of every determination. But also this latch is a determination for latching. Consequently, the absolute is truly completely indeterminate only when he is together the two opposite conditions, one of the full latch of every determination, the second, the infinite presence of every determination. Both these conditions are not determinate. One in the infinite absence, the other in the infinite presence. While it is easy to understand the infinite absence contained in a total zero, it is very difficult to understand a presence that is definite by the infinite. The infinite is not finite, so that what is definite is not able to measure the infinite with a precise number of definite units. Therefore, when the religions monotheists affirm that God is only one, are forgetting that he must be also zero, if he is truly absolute, and not conditioned by the unity. The unity, without any conditions, is quantified by the mathematics as the power n rises to zero. Its base n is infinite, in every possible number definite, except zero, which is not defined. The exponent of the power shows a power zero, not definite. Its result puts in action always the unity, whatever was the number n. Therefore, to say that God is only one implicates the existence of the numbers. Jews and Islam are simpletons, and they don't know the same sense of their affirmation about the unity of God. In fact, if God had not also the Trinity in his unity, he could not define the absolute latch of definitions that, on the contrary, exists when he is one and three. Let us see why saying that God is one and three we doesn't impose conditions to his absolute model. If you consider one volume, it is not definite in anything, since only its three sides may give definitions to it. But through three sides, we do not give greatness to the volume until we do not multiply them one by the other. Therefore, to say one volume and three its sides, while is a definition, is a latch of definition, latching the multiplication, and exists only the sum 1 plus 3 of 4 total definitions in the one line of the space-time, being 3 a space x, y, z equal and distinct volumes components, and being 1 as time, the t component of everything exists in the times one only line. To transform these 4 equal lines in one unity, it needs 3 real rotations clockwise. The first at the end of the first, the second at the end of the second, and the third at the end of the third, which turns the fourth line and close the 4 units in one only square. In this way is formed the frontal face of the square. To form the inverse face, starting always from the same 4 units, it needs 3 rotations anti-clockwise. If we present them one after the other, the 2 square has the square form of the infinite sign mathematic, which is 8 if the 2 squares are one on the other. When the unit is formed by the one line dividing the 8 in 2 squares, 7 lines represent the 7 days of all the creation of God. When we add to these 8 lines acting all in line, also the 2 dimensions, 1 plus 1, always in line, of the transverse area, 10 lines form in lines all the volume of God. Therefore, God is completely defined in line by 10 lines. In this way, it is absolute one, since it is numbered only through himself and forms a pure and ideal cycle having nothing to its external. This God 10 of 10 is units can be numbered only through its inverse, made by 10 raised to minus 1, equal to 1/10. In this way, 10 refers himself to 1/10 as every father refers to his first son. Only his first son makes of a man his father. In the same way, only 1/10 makes of a number is same determiner. Therefore, we have passed from the primitive and insufficient definition of God as the only one to discover 11 his talents equal and distinct, 10 as the talent of the Father, as the only one determiner, and 1 as God in his to exist as one. 11 is 10 plus 1. He is the creator, plus he is Holy Spirit of the unit. When Islam defines Allah as the only one creator, this faith is not able to add to the unit of Allah the correct attribution for numbering is to be a real creator. In this way, the Islam makes confusion between the unit and what is a creative talent. It is like to say that I am a good man and to know not what is the goodness. If I am able to define this goodness, taking it inside Allah, like the talent that the goodness is, they protest, saying that Allah is only one. They affirm, creator, this Allah, the only one creator, but protest when someone is able to define in the same quantitative way of the unity what of Allah is his creative talent. A lot of time I have tried to induce ability of reasoning to the Muslims, but they prefer not reasoning when they read the sacred scriptures. Ignorant, as affirmed, is ignorant interpretation by first, and everyone must observe it. Only an ignorant affirms that Allah, creator, is only one, and not two different definitions, Allah and creator. As Allah is a real definition, it is a name. As creator is a definition, it is a talent. For this Islam that does not use the reason, where one is a number, 10 is not a number involving a full creative cycle properly to the same unit. So, when one affirms that the creation made by the one equal God is made through one equal 10 cycle of God, I find only disapproving. Unfortunately, the faith is often in the hands of believers who are convinced to have merit if they believe an unreasonable thing. If faith was reasonable, that would merit it. By doing so, the faithful do not want to have any control by the reason and act like real fools. When the top of the reading of the scriptures comes one of the riches of faith, then unfortunately this is precisely when they think they have a great merit to believe in maximum nonsense. And they, brainwashed believers, receiving them. What usually happens when I meet a Muslim is that I am approached by one of them. It is always good people, but of those who read the scriptures with the brain closed for understanding the text. If in the text are used poetic forms to exalt certain faculties of God and to exalt the need to define the evil that exists among all men, the latching of imagination comes to believe that you can defeat evil of forever, condemning the bad man to hell. But it is not that in this way evil is defeated. It is defeated when all evil is defeated by the great reasons of goodness, and when everyone chooses to abandon the path of evil. Hitler was, no doubt, a bad person. If he, at the end of life, is judged, but it remains convinced of the truth he believes in, an eternity of punishment is not enough to overcome that idea. This man is only convinced to have not the necessary force against God. The winners are the reasons of the force and not of the love. And so it is punished the sinner and not the sin. And the sin is only the latch of the sufficient force. On the contrary, those who believe in an omnipotent God must believe in his ability to have convinced all the bad guys to change preferences. And if it survives Satan and his demons, with their good faith and reasons of evil, where is the omnipotence of God that does not convince Satan himself to repent? It would be enough reason to will a new reading of the sacred scriptures, but the fellow are not prepared. Stupidly, they read a reading guided by men who fail to distinguish the true from the literary forms, courtly, which often permeated all the sacred scriptures. They come and know my great interest for every problem, so they really desire to help me. And so they propose me their ancient interpretation, convinced of their goodness. I do not know if at the end my critical judgment has opened ways to the new intelligence of the same scriptures. I know that at the end they have lost their hope of helping me in their way. But I have not lost mine. Every right reason is with myself. God is a good essence, a good infinite essence, who has the ability to transform all the devil, all every seal in a great conversion. God has this ability, because at the end of this first moment of the life on this earth of Egypt, in which the fear, in which latch the freedom, since we are everyone commanded in this first way of our path toward God, there is our single conversion. God take ourselves one to one and convert him. God making way everyone that is gone over the death point is overturned in his advancing in the time and going toward its real past. The same love is observed in its contrary dynamic. This contrary dynamic is the first one. We start from the point in which all the design of our life is fixed, and it is the point in which our life is complete. It is that point that we name the point of the death. From that point, every man has the first experience, is compelled to return to his first moment of the conception. But this first path cannot be seen, cannot be perceived in a relative way, since it is the first one. The first one have not the possibility to have another thing before on which make the comparison, the relation. And so the first path returning of the life is invisible. Is the second that becomes visible, because on the first path, taken as example, the negative example, we can do the opposite perception, that relative one to its opposite. And so we perceive the life advancing in the positive direction by the comparison with the other, that is invisible one, and that we perceive in the third moment of our life, when have run all the second path of the same life, we have arrived to the end that is our start. And finally, in a relative way, against this second path, we finally are able to perceive the first path, that is in action, really now, and that we are not able to perceive now. We can perceive the first one when it is the third one, and so also our life is first and three. The second is only a wave of passage, is only a earth of Egypt in which we are compelled to perceive our life as the inverse of the commanded and the design. And we are only making the transformation of one design in an apparent world of things, of masses, of times, of flows, of reality, of warm, of molecules, of the light intensity. But all these things are only ideas of our mind that is with the ability, with the talent of God, because our software is exactly the 10 and the 1. We are God, one, that is 10 in its talent, having also the talent of the creation. And when the Muslims say that the world is made by ourselves, it is not wrong, but it is made by the part of ourselves that is the omnipotent God, who has fixed them. It is not our myself of this moment. This our presence in this moment is existing in the second path of our Trinity observation of the life. And so, being we with the same ability, with the same talent of God, we are able to understand God, to perceive it in ourselves. But because of this God is not the omnipotent God that everyone is in this sign, is not believed as the same God. But these men of faith are not able to understand that a thing is a design. Another is the interpreter of a story. The interpreter is living. The history is a thing, is an appearance of the matter that is in movement. Matter in body, matter in person, matter in everything of our material world. But our presence is not that of the matter, is that of the spirit, is that soul that is part of the only one that exists. Allah is only one existing, and his ability, his talent, ten, is the talent of a father that may be the father of ourselves, and we the son of this father. In this way we have a great father in the heaven, but we are son of this father, since the ability to transform the numbers of a devotee, of a design binary one, are ourselves. Ourselves have the ability to transform this design as a virus, having the 10th cycle as its infesting cycle, able to transform the numbers in vision of life, of matter, of time, and of everything we are perceiving. So, today we have to realize in ourselves a vision more advanced in the understanding of the Absolute and of the relations of our to be relative and our be in Absolute, since it is everyone, it is always the same essence, the only essence who is living, that of God, who can be or undefined or really incarnated in every and infinite types of life, all the possible ones. Only in this way God is absolute, since he is zero of a lack of a definition, and so absolute, but absolute also in the way in action that is made by every opposition. Because if the world is made by plus one and minus one in every opposition, plus one and minus one exist as the zero, that is the addition of one to minus one. So the world complex made by matter and antimatter, space-time, positive and negative, and all the opposition generally described by the Father, the Creator, and the creation, the first creation, in this type general of representation of the action and the reaction in this fundament we have the same zero of the absolute logic of definition. And these words, so, is the demonstration of the strength of God, since the ability to put in existence a zero.